friends, and welcome back to my channel. It's me, Jenny Shastanley again, and today I'm going to review the book Science Comics, Crows, Genius Birds. This book was written by Killa Vanderkloot. This book has 122 pages, and you might be able to see that this book is a comic book. So, of course, crows are birds, and like most birds, they can fly. Crows belong to a family called Corvidae, and their genus is called Corvus. Do you know the scientific name for a crow? It's not crow, because that's ridiculous. It's called Corvus brachyrhynchus. That's pretty long. It's the scientific name for a crow. In plain words, Corvus brachyrhynchus means the American crow. Some people think that crows and ravens are the same, but are they? No way is that true. Ravens are actually much bigger than the crows. As you can see, the raven, or the bigger one, is larger than the crow, or the smaller one. And also, ravens croak, while crows don't croak, they caw. Most of you may know a story of called The Thirsty Crow. There was this crow flying by. He spotted a pitcher of water. He tried to reach it, but it was too low for him. But he had to think, how do I reach this water without having to fly in there? Because I'm much too big. But then, I have an idea. Maybe I could use those stones. Then he picked up some stones and dropped them in the pitcher. The water level rose higher and higher, and he could reach the water. So that's the story of the thirsty crow. But do you know why the crow did that? Because crows are some of the most intelligent birds of any other, because their brains are larger than most birds' brains anyway. Also, their neurons are packed way more densely than those of a mammal's brain, like yours and mine. So, what things are in a crow's diet? Well, the answer is anything, because crows eat vegetables, they eat grains, they eat fruits, they eat worms, beetles, snakes, frogs, and anything. So, crows have anything in their diet, but crows can also eat some disgusting things. They have been spotted running around in garbage eating it, and they have also been spotted eating human vomit. Yuck for us, but that must be a yum for the crows. Crows are very social birds, so once they mate, they have offspring and then make one large family. It starts with the parents, then the offspring, or the babies, then the older siblings and helpers who always help take care of all of the offspring. They all roost together in the winters, and also they can sometimes be up to 2 million crows strong. Now that is very powerful. They've also been known to mimic things such as dog barks, cat meows, even human words. Crows have been saying things like hello, and they also pick up naughty words too. Well, what's the difference between a chicken and a crow whenever they both hatch? Well, that's all because crows are blind and helpless. They are altricial, so whenever they hatch, they're blind and helpless. The mom and older siblings need to feed the baby or babies frequently, while chicks, on the other hand, are precocial, which means they're able to walk and feed themselves and are usually very curious. Have you ever seen a dead crow on the road or anywhere? And imagine this, there's a dead crow on the ground and there are thousands of crows sitting, perching up in trees. And then one crow goes, caw, caw, caw. And the rest of the crows keep going, caw, caw, until then dozens or hundreds or even thousands of crows are in the sky with all that caw, caw, caw noise everywhere. So, then they, in utter silence, in a couple minutes, whoosh, they disappear. That's called a crow funeral. There's one question I would like to ask you. Can crows use tools like you and me? The answer is yes! Crows have the ability to use tools. But did you know that they can also make tools? That seems impossible, but that actually is true. Crows can make tools out of pandanus leaves. They can make hook tools by cutting down twigs. Both of them are used to grab insects and grubs from trees. They can make their own resource. They can make tools by using their very own resources. In tests, if there's any wire and there's something they need to hook, they can just bend the wire right up and scoop. They've got the thing out. Did you know that crows have extreme memory? So one day, to test it, a couple researchers had two different masks, one that was neutral and the other were dangerous. They walked by with the neutral masks on. The crows just ignored them. But with the dangerous mask, they caught and banded the wild crows. So whenever the rest of the crows saw them, peck, peck, caw, caw, they started attacking them. And then they came back with the neutral mask, the crows ignored them. The dangerous mask, they kept on attacking. It wasn't the first generation only, but the next generation of crows also remembered those dangerous masks. So whenever they saw them, peck, peck, caw, caw, they attack those people too. So remember, never mess with a crow. Because the crows will remember your face, and if they see you again, they'll start to attack you, like what usual crows would do. Did you know that also crows can be your friends? If you give them food daily, they can come by and leave tiny gifts in the feeding spot. And to show appreciation, they leave small gifts like keys, and they leave multiple other things to the humans. Some people think crows are not beautiful at all, and they are not intelligent. But did you know that those people are actually very wrong? Crows are beautiful and very intelligent and talented. So everyone, go and read this book to learn more about crows. Friends, thanks for watching my videos. Please like, comment, share, and subscribe to my channel to stay tuned in on my new videos. I'll fly over to my next video. See you there.